Hello children, welcome to science. Today we are going to learn lesson 4, air. In this lesson we will learn rims of the earth and atmosphere, different layers of atmosphere, composition of air, combustion and burning, survival of living being and importance of air. Rims of the earth. A planet having four different regions of rims. The rim of land is called lithosphere, the rim of water is called hydrosphere, and the rim of air is called atmosphere. The zone where land, water, and air meet is called biosphere. Children, lithosphere refers land, hydrosphere refers water. Water in the sense all the water bodies. Atmosphere refers air. Next, atmosphere. Earth is surrounded by a layer of gases which is called the atmosphere. It is made up of complex layers of gases at different temperatures extending to a great height from the surface of the earth. When we learn about atmosphere, we should learn about greenhouse effect. Okay. What is greenhouse effect? Atmosphere absorbs the heat from the sun and helps the earth to stay warm. This is called greenhouse effect. It helps us feel not so cold during the night and not too hot during the day. The atmosphere plays a major role in controlling weather patterns and climate. The winds and the rainfalls are regulated by the atmosphere. Layers of atmosphere. Though the atmosphere looks like a single homogeneous layer, it is divided into different layers based on the chemical composition and the process that takes place in the layer. There are five layers, namely troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and exosphere. The troposphere. Troposphere is important because all weather changes like the wind, cyclones, storms, etc. take place here. Temperature increases with increasing height in the troposphere. It gets colder as we go up. The troposphere extends to about 18 kilometers over the equator and 8 kilometers above the poles. The stratosphere. Stratosphere has the ozone layer, which absorbs the ultraviolet radiations from the sun. If there were no ozone, life would not be possible. Because of the absorption of the ultraviolet radiation, the temperature steadily rises in the stratosphere. Next, mesosphere. The layer above the stratosphere is mesosphere. Weather balloons can fly up to this layer. This layer helps in burning up meteorites that enters the Earth's atmosphere. If this did not happen, we would have frequent meteorite hits. Next, the thermosphere. Thermosphere is a very interesting layer. This layer is also called the ionosphere because it has electrically charged ions. They help in communication and in transmitting radio signals of different wavelengths. Radio, television, mobile communications and other satellite communications would not be possible without this layer. Satellites are docked in this layer for communication. The last one is exosphere. Space shuttles and space capsules roam in exosphere, beyond which is interplanetary space. Next, composition of air. The atmosphere is predominantly made of nitrogen. This gas is converted into nitrates and is absorbed by plants. Nitrogen is a major requirement for proteins, which are the building blocks of life. Nitrogen's percentage in our air is 78. Next is oxygen. the life-giving gas. Its percentage in air is 21. While animals breathe in oxygen and breathe out carbon dioxide, plants take in carbon dioxide during photosynthesis and release oxygen. The remaining 1% is other gases like xenon, neon, hydrogen, helium, krypton, and carbon dioxide. The composition of air changes slightly from place to place and also from season to season. For example, air over industrial cities usually has a higher amount of carbon dioxide in it than the air over open spaces. Air in coastal areas may have more water vapor than inland areas. Air also contains more water vapor in the rainy season. The amount of dust in the air is more in windy places than in other areas. Next, importance of air for survival of plants and animals. Like all living beings, plants also respire. It takes in oxygen, breaks down carbohydrates, and gives out carbon dioxide. But in the photosynthesis, it is different. In the presence of sunlight, as we all know, the green leaves of plants photosynthesizes by taking in carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and giving out oxygen. The air transfer during respiration and photosynthesis is carried out through small pores on the leaves called stomata. Next, transpiration in animal. We breathe in air and oxygen present in it react chemically with the digested food in our body to produce carbon dioxide and water along with energy. This process is called respiration. Children, with this I conclude this lesson. Thank you.